people in the audience this evening. So, a very good evening to you all, and welcome to the Concerto Festival. And I can't believe it's 2 years since this event happened last. 2 years since we actually had one of these lights catching fire because it was so hot. And this concert seems to often land on a very hot day. So we had that small incident with, it was a smoking light really, but it did set off the alarms on that occasion. We've taken the precaution today of only lighting these slightly hot lights about 5 minutes ago. We haven't had them on all day. And the other thing that I've noticed is this concert often seems to coincide with a notable international football match. So occasionally we've had quite small audiences. We've even had pupils in the orchestra trying to bunk off to go and watch the football. I see tonight it's Germany versus France. So that's quite a biggie, and I hope avid football fans amongst you manage to catch up with that later on catch up. Today we've had the disruption of a little bird, which is up there at the moment, but it won't be up there for long. It does the rounds. I hope it's been enjoying our music. I very much doubt it's going to find a way out until the chapel is nice and quiet when we've all gone and it flies down below here and leaves by one of the exits, which are on my left and right. So please don't be too distracted by the bird and the occasional chirp. We've had some very warm rehearsing this afternoon in preparation for what promises to be a really high-class concert with a huge variety of concerto movements selected from the Baroque, classical and romantic periods. As is our custom in the Concerto Festival, we like to showcase the orchestra at the beginning and at the end of the concert. And this evening, we've chosen to do this with four movements from Handel's Water Music Suite No. 2. The first three of these movements will open the concert, and then the alla hornpipe will be our finale this evening. And spare a thought for the trumpets in that movement, four of them back there, because they have a stratospheric part way up high in the clarino register, which was typical of Baroque trumpet writing before the invention of valves, in fact a long time before valve instruments were introduced. Our soloists have been working extremely hard in preparation for this evening's concert, and we have 10 contrasting concerto movements in the programme. I'm particularly delighted that we have a pupil in year 9, Seth Hamlin, performing a solo, notably on the bassoon. It takes immense courage to perform a solo in public, not least with an orchestral accompaniment. And to do this as one of the youngest members in the senior school is really commendable. So we're greatly looking forward to your performance, Seth. No pressure. And I've said this already, but we're really pleased to have extended an invitation to parents of soloists to join us face-to-face this evening. But, of course, those of you who are watching us back at home through our live stream on YouTube, you might like to know that you can find the programme for this evening's concert by clicking on the description below the image so you can see what's coming up in the programme and, more importantly, who our soloists are who will be performing at the front here. So I think that's enough talking from me. So picture the scene now. A royal flotilla floating down the Thames in London about 350 years ago, and Handel's water music drifting across from the musician's barge. Now in front of you are the musicians, and you are the royal consort.
Thank you.
must have had very good bassoonists. Sadly, the role of ladies back in the Baroque period was such that they weren't to be seen performing in public. That was the role of men in orchestras. So these young ladies, who were hugely gifted and talented musicians, gave concerts from behind screens. So we're very pleased that we can actually see you performing. Not that you're a young lady, but it's nice to see our performers. So Seb's going to perform the bassoon concerto in E minor, the slow movement, and we're going to use the harpsichord here for the first time in 2 years. It's a little bit out of tune. I did tune it this afternoon. It's come a long way, but it's just lapsed a little bit since then. So try to bear with the tuning.
Thank you.
I'm sure all of you will recognise this. And for Mozart, the clarinet was quite special. There was a family friend that he often wrote for, and he was very proud of his clarinet writing. I might mention, I was very worried on Sunday because Ed damaged his hand quite significantly, and it was a bit touch and go. But honestly, you would not notice, and the rehearsal that took this afternoon was superb. So let's look forward to a wonderful performance.
Let's just tune up again, shall we?
these B-flat trumpets, which really aren't designed to play this piece. It's written for a piccolo trumpet, a much higher trumpet. So the Laruna, first movement from Lily.
Thank you.
C's there, and if anyone's played the trumpet before, you'll know how high that is. Now, we move on to the Romantic period, one of the great camera concertos of the Romantic period, by Grieg. Sasha is going to come to the front now. You're going to rotate the camera, in fact, so there'll be a bit of stage management at the front here. And then we're going to hear the slow movement from the Greek caricature. she's playing on a tiny sopranino recorder, but it really projects, it really pierces through the texture, and it makes more volume than all of us at the front here. So we're looking forward to the slow movement of Vivaldi's Recorder Concerto in C major. Thank you. And Seb's going to play the first movement, which includes a cadenza near the end. So it's spotlight on Seb, and during the cadenza, the orchestra can relax, and it's over to you.
Thank you.
brought the Royal Consort once again, and this is the fourth movement from the second suite, the hornpipe.
Thank you.
you'd agree with me, we've had a thrilling concert, ladies and gentlemen. And I really take my hat off to all the soloists this evening. It's amazing to perform in public in the first place, but to synchronise that with an orchestra and to do that as a school pupil is incredible. So a big round of applause for our soloists. Children, but please don't mingle